Welcome back to Lewis Bonnet Field as we are just about ready for second half action. Tim Stubbs flying solo this evening here in what they call Cowboy Country. McNeese State from Lake Charles, Louisiana, 37-14 our score. UAPB will kick it off to start the second half. The game a little bit closer than what the score indicates. If you're just joining us, we were tied at 14 early second quarter before a big kickoff return by Deontay Spencer of about 83 yards. A couple plays later, they were able to go in for a score and then went on a little bit of a run and scored again before halftime. And all of a sudden, bing, bang, boom, it's 37-14. Get into some stats for you in just a moment. But here is Strickland on the second half kickoff. Spencer takes it about 3 yards deep. 10, 15, 20, look out, here we go again. 30, 40, he's dangerous. Finally taken down at the 40-yard line. Andre Mitchell and his speed, luckily, was able to take down Spencer, or he would have been off to the races again. He is a very, very dangerous specialist player. Just underway, second half here. 37-14. McNeese State with the lead and the football to start the second half of play. Dropping back over the middle, it is caught, a little crossing pattern. Forced out of bounds right at the first down marker. That was Bush on the catch. And that is, once again, Stroud in there. Cody Stroud, the quarterback for McNeese. Takes the snap. Crossing pattern, nearly the same play at the 40. And Bush taken down at the 33-yard line. As McNeese State, back-to-back pass plays. Andre Mitchell on the stop for UAPB, but not before another Cowboy first down. Pretty much the same identical play, back-to-back. Stroud in the shotgun, he'll have three wide to the left. Marcus Wiltz, the running back, to the right. Coming out of the flat here, they can throw it to him. Instead, they're going to go deep at the five. End zone, walks in, touchdown, Cowboys. McNeese State scores again. Just four plays into the second half, Stroud was able to connect with Ernest Celesti. Right here out of Lake Charles, Louisiana. Extra point coming up here. Kick is up and it is good. 14-12 to play, we'll step aside. McNeese State tacking on another touchdown. They lead it now 44-14 over UAPB. The Golden Lions will receive the football for the first time in the second half when we come back. Welcome back here to McNeese State University, UAPB and McNeese State. 14-12 to play here in the third quarter. Early on, it only took McNeese State all of 48 seconds to score here in the second half. They now lead 44-14. This game was tied at 14, folks, if you're just joining us. And since then, it's been at McNeese State rolling, getting things going as they had a big kickoff return right after UAPB tied it. And then a questionable call on a safety that myself and Monty Coleman and the coaching staff and some of the players for UAPB certainly thought it should have been a touchback instead of a safety, a very bizarre play. And it seems like ever since then it's been all McNeese State. And that's where we are right now. Set to boot it away is Rome. Rome kicking it deep and taken right at the goal line by Mitchell. Mitchell tripped up at the 10-yard line, but then kept his footing for just a little bit as he got up to about the 15, maybe 16. Or check that on the return for the first time. The freshman out of Pine Bluff High, Walter Ashley. Good to see him out there. had a monster career for Pine Bluff High. So Ashley got his first opportunity there. Gets up to the 16-yard line. Anderson going to throw it. Got Dexter Bryan at the 20. Works his way up to about the 21-yard line. Short gain, but positive yardage. Louisiana native. Gain of 5. Second down and 5 coming up here for UAPV. Trailing big, but fighting. Much better energy here tonight for the Golden Lions. Over the middle, nearly picked off. Dangerous pass, boy. Going for Bryan again, a little short pass there, and Thompson, who had an interception earlier in the game, was vying for his second pick. Third down and 5 here for Anderson. Shotgun. Takes the snap. Gonna throw it over the middle, and it is caught. Short pass play, but it is caught by Dexter Bryant, and just enough for a first down at the 25. They'll give him forward progress to the 26. That'll move the chains for UAPB, and that's a positive. Stretch play, handoff, Smith to the 27, just a yard gain on the play. Jamie Smith really ran the ball very well in the first half for UAPB. 9 carries for 80 yards, had a 50-yard run, a touchdown, averaging 9 yards a carry. Ben Anderson, 7 carries for 36 yards. Jeremiah Young, 2 for 2 yards and a touchdown. Ben Anderson was 7 of 15 for 72 yards. Sacked twice, no touchdowns, 1 pick. In that first half, he's going to throw it here. Short pass play. It is caught by Isaiah Ferguson. Stretching for the first down. He's got it. A gain of 11 on the play up to the 30, just shy of the 37-yard line. Great effort there by Ferguson. UAPB in a no-huddle attack here as they're trying to get a little tempo going. Shotgun here for Ben Anderson. 12-22 and counting, third quarter. 44-14. McNeese State up big. Bryan in motion. Pump fake it to him. Now they're going to go back over the middle, and it is incomplete. Had it for just a moment, but not able to hang on to it. It was Brandon Kinsey on the... He was the intended receiver. Couldn't hang on to it. Had it for just a moment. Hit the turf. Stops the clock at 12:08 here in the third. Gonna throw it. Going deep up the left sideline. Intended receiver was Ladarius Eckwood. He got tangled up there. Eckwood got tangled up with Guy Morgan and falls incomplete. Going to bring up third down and 10. Third down and 10 here. Ball at the UAPB 37. Shotgun snap for Anderson. Steps up. Dumping it back right to Smith at the 37, maybe the 38-yard line. It's going to be well shy of the first down. Gets up back to the original line of scrimmage, maybe, and that's about all. Maybe a gain of 1. So flag on the play. It's going to be a legal motion on UAPB. It'll be declined and fourth down coming up. Strickland on to punt it away. The dangerous Deontay Spencer back deep. He'll take it. Backpedaling at the 22. Looked like a block in the back there. Branch trying to get Spencer. He blows by him and then steps out of bounds at about the 44-yard line, but it should be a block in the back around the 26-yard line against McNeese State. With that, we are ready to resume play after the timeout here. First and 10 for McNeese State at their own 16-yard line. Handoff off the left side there. I believe that was Bennett on the carry. And taken down by Kyle Walker and Dryan Harris. Bennett ran it pretty well in that first half as well. He'll get some carries, some opportunities here in the second half of this one. Gain of 5 on that carry, so second down and 5. Hand off again, straight ahead. Gain of 2, maybe 3. We'll call it third down and 2 coming up here. Kelvin Bennett, 5'11", 180, sophomore out of Bleakwood, Texas, Newton High School. They'll fake it to him here, throw it to the big fullback at the 35, and upended there, maybe the 36-yard line. Andre Mitchell on the stop, but not before Kendall Thomas gets the first down for the Cowboys. They'll move the chains. Bennett, the lone back, he'll take the handoff, stretch play to the left, stacked up right there. Good job by that Golden Lion interior front. Troy Goss and TQ Mims coming in there for a little run support. I believe Jerian Harris in there as well. Gain of about 1.5 yards. Bring up second down, we'll call it second down and 8. The ball on the McNeese State 38-yard line, 9:33 and counting. Third quarter, McNeese State leading 44-14. They hand it off to Long, the big fullback. He's driving a couple of would-be tacklers up to about the 45-yard line. A host of Golden Lions in on the stop there. Kyle Walker and Brandon Miner in there for UAPB. 8:50 and counting. It's going to be third. Let's see. They're going to get enough for the first down, I believe. Nope, just a little short. We'll call it third and about 1/2 yard. So third and very short here. They'll give it to Long again. He's taken down and a nice tackle there. I believe he got enough for the first down, but a pretty nice hit by Tavion Garrison. Strong safety freshman out of Little Rock Parkview. But not before Long picked up the first down, but a nice tackle there by Garrison. He's made a couple of nice plays tonight. Clock rolling at 8:10. Here in the third, McNeese State in control, up 44-14. Hand off again, Long hit in the backfield. This time Troy Goss with a nice tackle and maybe a loss on the play. Nice play there by Troy Goss. We'll call it no gain, second down and 10. Ball spotted at the McNeese State 47-yard line. Stroud still in it, quarterback Bennett, the lone back. He sprints out into the flat. They'll dump it off to him right there. Big block as Bennett is able to get into UAPB territory to the 47-yard line. Antonio Jenkins, 6'1", 215, redshirt sophomore out of Watson Chapel there in Pine Bluff with the tackle, but gain of about six there. Going to bring up third down and four for McNeese State. Stroud looks left, throws left, got a man complete. First down for the Cowboys at the 40-yard line. Jenkins on the stop, but not before William Rickman, receiver out of Lafayette, Louisiana, picks up the first down at the 40, and then to move the chains for the Cowboys again. Clock will roll at 6:26 and counting. Fast-moving third quarter here. You know, McNeese State wants to eat up some clock with the big lead here in the second half. They'll hand it off again straight ahead, and then Bennett rips off about 7, maybe 8 yards there, right up the middle, up to the 33-yard line. A gain of 7 there for Bennett. Stroud will operate under center this time. And Bennett again is lone back. Bennett to the left, stacked up this time. Great job by that UAPB defense. Troy Goss. And again, Jenkins in there for UAPB. Going to bring up third down and four for the Cowboys at their own 35-yard line. Lone back is Bennett. Play action rolling to his left. Now throwing into the flat to the left. Big hit caught by Antonio Jenkins on the nice hit. And it's going to be a little short of the first down as they got it out to the left flat there. Kendall Thomas, their tight end, caught it, but he's going to be about a yard short. Fourth down and one coming up here, and kind of too far for a field goal and too close to punt it. McNeese State's going to go for it here. Fourth and one at the UAPB 31-yard line. Long back is Bennett. Too wide to the right here. Under center, Stroud. Hand off straight ahead, and Bennett has the first down. Jerrion Harris and Duncan the third on the stop, but not before another Cowboy first down. Clock continues to roll, 4.5 and counting. McNeese State really had a lot of ball control here in the third quarter. They scored in the first 48 seconds to go up 44-14. And then they've just started milking it here. Trying to get to the edge and chased out of bounds by Brandon Miner. Was able to take Bennett down at about the 24-yard line. Let's see, they're giving, yeah, 24. Gain of 3 on the play. That'll bring up second down and 7. Bennett the lone back again. Delayed handoff. Bennett cut back to the right, taken down at a, right at the 20-yard line. They'll give him forward progress. Maybe the 19, we'll see. Taken down there by Quan Cummings Jr. Brings up third down and two here for McNeese State. Right at the 20. Hand off Jenkins. Looks like he's going to have the first down at about the 16-yard line. And they're just kind of slowly bleeding them to death here. No big chunks of yardage, but just enough to get a first down on third and short and fourth down. In inches, fourth and one a moment ago, but just 3 and 4 yards at a time here. .246 and counting in the third. Dylan Long, the new back, he'll take it. Straight ahead. Short yardage that time for Long, the fullback, as picks up 3, maybe 4 yards there on the carry. Caught second down and 6 for McNeese State, as they have really held onto this ball for a long, long time, over half of the quarter in just this one drive. Bootleg, play action, gets hit as he throws it, tipped in the end zone and couldn't hold on to it, incomplete. He was looking for Ronaldo Young, and Young had a hand on it, but couldn't hold on. Stops the clock at 2:03, brings up third down and 6. From the UAPB 12-yard line. Stroud under pressure, throws as he gets hit, breaking a tackle at the 5, and Long, Dylan Long's gonna go in for an easy touchdown. Under pressure, Stroud was, but he was able to dump it off to his fullback, and Long shook a would-be tackler at about the 12 and then went in for the score. With 1:56 left here in the third, and McNeese State tacks on some more unneeded points here. It's 50-14 now, with 1:56 to go before the fourth quarter. The extra point is up and it is good. We will step aside. 1:56 to go in the third, and a long, long methodical drive there by the Cowboys of McNeese State. They add on to their big lead. They now lead it 51-14. UAPB to receive the kickoff right after this timeout. Welcome back to Lewis Bonnet Field here at McNeese State University. Tim Stubbs flying solo this evening. Carl will be back with me next week as UAPB will have their home opener and conference opener. Jackson State did beat Alabama State tonight. Louisiana Monroe up big 48-7 over Grambling that game late in the fourth quarter. 30-23 Jackson State over Alabama State. Get some more scores here. Let's see. Mississippi State 51-7 over Alcorn. Tuskegee beat Alabama A&M 23-7. Delta State beat Mississippi Valley 24-14. Texas State up 28-3 over Prairie View. That game almost a final. I believe that is a final now. Northwest State 55-14 over Southern. There's the kickoff. Going to be taken from the 2-yard line. Made one man miss and then blasted at the 5. That was Walter Ashley again on the return, but didn't really have much of a chance on that one. The UAPB, they'll give him the 6-yard line on forward progress, but Walter Ashley, I think he's going to be a great player here at UAPB once it's all said and done. Got a lot of talent. Back in there at tailback, Jamie Smith, freshman from Camden, Arkansas. UAPB kind of working on some things now, getting ready for conference play, as this one is pretty much done as far as the outcome of the winner and loser. I hate to be that way with 1:45 left in the third. Anything can happen. I do understand that, but it is 51-14 right now. McNeese State with a big lead, tied at 14 at one point, and then the game just kind of turned and got away from UAPB there in that second quarter. A few things happened. Hand off, trying to go outside, little cutback, and then McNeese State's just ready for him. Three or four Cowboy jerseys right there to take down Jamie Smith. Short gain, and going to bring up third down and call it third and nine. Ferguson, Bryant, Swain, and Eckwood in there for UAPB for the receiving core. Smith alone back just to the left of Anderson. Anderson will take the snap. In the end zone, Anderson in trouble, gets away from one Cowboy, and now taken down back at the line of scrimmage. And maybe lost a half yard, so we'll call it, say, lost a yard. Fourth and 11. And Strickland's going to have to punt it away again. That McNeese State front four is really getting after Anderson all night. Could be the final play of the quarter as Strickland in the back of the end zone here, 15 seconds and counting. They could elect to let the quarter run out. I believe that's what they're going to do. So that's going to end the third quarter of play. McNeese State will head to the fourth quarter leading big here at home in Lake Charles, Louisiana. 51-14, McNeese State over UAPB. We'll have the fourth quarter coming up in just a moment. Back here at Lewis Bonnet Field, set for the fourth quarter, and it's going to be a punt coming up here to start the quarter. Tyler Strickland doing double duty this season. Place kicker, kicking off, field goal or punting as well. Aaron Godwin was the punter the last couple years. Hands off that duty now to Tyler Strickland. This couple of times tonight he's been punting deep out of the back of his own end zone. New return man is David Bush. I'm not too upset about that, as Spencer is been very dangerous all night, returning just about everything that's coming to him, and this is going to be angled out of bounds at about the 40-yard line. Let's see where they actually get it. They're going to say 36, so not a very good net there. It's going to give it back to McNeese State as they lead 51-14 over UAPB. 14:56 to go in the ball game as we're now in the fourth quarter of play. Hand off straight ahead, and a short gain of about 2 yards there for the Cowboys. That's long again, I believe. They're actually going to give it to another fullback, getting some new names in there, some new players. That's Devin Eaglin, a 5'10", 225 redshirt freshman out of Westlake, Louisiana. Gain of two there on the play. Clock rolls at 14:25 and counting. It's going to be Eaglin again. A little bit of running room up over the 30 to the 30-yard line. And we'll give him the 31-yard line and a gain of about 3, maybe 4 yards. Bring up third down and 4 for the Cowboys at the UAPB 31. .13:47 and counting, 51-14, all McNeese State. Eaglin will stay in there, two receivers to the left. Handoff again, right side, breaking a tackle. Eaglin hard running up to the 22-yard line and a first down for the Cowboys. Tyler Bolfing is back in there. Came in for one series in the first half and led his Cowboys to a touchdown on that series. Now he's back in there, probably will play the rest of this game for the Cowboys of McNeese State, 13-30 and counting, and a big lead for the Cowboys. As I mentioned, they're in the Southland Conference. One of their big rivals, the UCA Bears out of Conway in the Southland Conference. And they'll milk the clock, take some time off here as Bolfing looks into the sideline, gets the play in the huddle with 14 on the play clock. Under center, handoff again, Eaglin, nice tackle there off the right side. Look, that was Jenkins again. He's been active here in the second half for UAPB. Antonio Jenkins, 6'1", 215, red shirt, sophomore out of Watson Chapel. Again, they will continue just to kind of milk the clock here as Bolfing looks over to the sideline. Again, with about 14, 15 seconds on the play clock, gets the call in. Gonna see a lot of Eaglin, the big fullback, is gonna get a lot of carries here in the fourth quarter. He'll take another one here. Nice cutback to the 15-yard line. Tackle there by UAPB's Caleb Ely, 6'2", 280 redshirt, sophomore out of Houston, Texas. .11:45 and counting. These are the games that are tough for the broadcasters as they're just kind of mathematical. Waiting on it just kind of roll down here. You get a chance to look at some new players as Eaglin rumbles his way right into Andre Mitchell at about the 12-yard line. Looks to be enough for another Cowboy first down. But Cowboys are just content with milking the clock and doesn't make for very exciting football, but it gets the job done. Ball spotted at the 12, first and 10 for McNeese State. Bolfing gets the signal. Under center, stretch play to the left, cutting back, straight ahead, stacked up at about the 14-yard line. Host of Golden Lions in there. That was John Trey Tillman, his first carry, 5'9", 190 tailback, freshman out of Baldwin, Louisiana. And 10 minutes and 15 seconds and counting. It'll be second down and 7 from the 9-yard line. McNeese State putting this game on ice. Hand off again, right side, cut back at the 5, driving, trying to get in the end zone. Jenkins is fighting, and the ball is fumbled, but not before another McNeese State touchdown. John Trey Tillman, back-to-back carries, and boy, just fighting for extra yardage. He lost the ball, but not before he crossed the plane for the touchdown. That's the second time tonight that McNeese State has scored a touchdown where they fumbled right at the goal line, but the officials say they got it across before the fumble took place. So 9:58 to go, another touchdown for McNeese State. Extra point coming up here for Rome is good. We'll step aside here with 9:58 remaining in the fourth quarter. It's now 58-14, McNeese State up big. They'll kick it off to UAPB when we return. 9:58 remaining here from Lewis Bonnet Field at McNeese State University, Lake Charles, Louisiana. Tim Stubbs solo this evening. Glad to be with you, but I don't like this score. 58-14 all McNeese State as they had a 14-all tie early in the second quarter, and boy, it has been all Cowboys since then. A very, very good Southland Conference team here at McNeese State. They'll be right at the top of their conference once again. A great football tradition here at McNeese State. They're set to kick it away after another long, well, not too long, a 36-yard drive, but it seemed like it took them about 8 or 9 plays. They just 3-4 yards a pop on the carrying the football and getting some other backs involved. Backup quarterback Bolfing has been in on the action here tonight, and 5, 6, 7 different running backs. Here's the kickoff by Rome, and it's going to be knelt down by Ashley in the end zone. Walter Ashley seeing some action here tonight, his first touches of the season. So the Golden Lions will take over on the touchback at their own 25, down big, get a chance to work on some things going into conference play. Next Saturday, game on ESPNU, but we need the fans to pack it out. They need your support. It's scratch these two first games. They mean nothing as far as the SWAC championship is concerned. Hand off Jamie Smith, gets up to about the 26-yard line, a gain of 1. Kind of start the season over starting next week for UAPB. See if they can get that first win at home and who knows, get on a roll and see what'll happen. I know it'll help getting some players back on the field for sure. Shotgun snap. Anderson in trouble. Gets hit hard as he goes down at the 26-yard line. No gain on the play, and certainly don't want to get him hurt here. Brings up 3rd down and 9. So he kind of looks at his hand a little bit there, and I'm sure Coach Coleman, that's the last thing he wants to see happen is this starting quarterback get hurt in a blowout game with conference season starting next week. 3rd and 9, they'll clear the backfield out. Anderson wants to toss it, he'll throw it. Wide throw, but caught by Dez Beverly out of bounds at about the 29-yard line, just a gain of 3, so 4th down and 6 coming up. UAPB is gonna have to punt it away again. A lot of 3 and outs here tonight after they got things going early in the game with a couple of touchdowns, and since then, McNeese State has done a really nice job of shutting UAPB's offensive attack down. .830 and counting. Strickland's kick is going to be caught. No, boy, big hit. Ball is fumbled and corralled by the Cowboys at the 28-yard line, but a big hit there, big collision on the punt. My goodness. First down for McNeese State. Glad nobody got hurt out of that. They'll take over at the 28 with 8:23 to play in the ball game, leading UAPB 58-14. We'll resume play here, 8:23 to go in the fourth, all McNeese State. Hand off again, straight ahead and stacked up at the line of scrimmage. Whole bunch of Golden Lions in there. New quarterback coming in here is Will Briscoe, 6'3", 180 sophomore out of Baton Rouge, Louisiana. He'll take over for the Cowboys as they lead with half a quarter left, 58-14. Eaglin, the fullback. The long back, he'll take the handoff straight ahead. Hit hard initially, right at the line of scrimmage by Willie Duncan, the third, and bounces forward for a couple of yards. So it's going to be third down and about four coming up here. As we approach the 7-minute mark of the fourth quarter, and again, they'll just milk the clock here. McNeese State will, as they have the big lead. Briscoe, the new quarterback in there. Devin Eaglin, the lone back, takes another handoff. Jenkins is there to help stack him up. Gain of about four, close to another first down for the Cowboys. And it will be enough for another McNeese State. Well, they have just held on to the ball here pretty much this whole second half. And UAPB's had some three and outs, and McNeese State has put together some 6-, 7-, 8-minute type drives and just kept the ball away from the Golden Lions. That's how you put away a big lead. Don't let the team come back. They can't do it if they don't have the football. Briscoe under center. Stretch play to the right. Again, Eaglin stacked up. No gain.
Devin Eaglin near the 40-yard line. Gain of two.
Well, they'll give him a, they'll call it gain of two. It really about a maybe a yard and a half. Briscoe looks over to the sideline as they continue to work the clock. He'll get the play in about 10 seconds on the play clock. Under center. Hand off again off the right side, and again stacked up, and a nice job there. Duncan the third. And Anthony Smith.
Loss of about a yard.
John Trey Tillman scored a touchdown a moment ago. He took that carry. Third down and nine coming up for the Cowboys. We approach the 5-minute mark. Eaglin back in there. He'll take the handoff straight ahead once again. Couple of more yards up to the 42-yard line. We'll give him about the 43. It'll be fourth down and about five coming up here for McNeese State, and they'll have a rare punt here tonight. And John Bro coming in to punt it away. Andre Mitchell is the deep man, standing back at about the 15 of UAPB. Mitchell backpedaling and catches it falling down at the 10-yard line. That's where the Golden Lions will take over, first and 10 at their own 10 with 4:06 remaining in the ball game. UAPB trailing McNeese State 58-14. It was 37-14 at halftime. Met all McNeese State here in the second half. We were tied at 14 at the 14:30 mark in the second quarter. That's the closest the Golden Lions would get. .406 to go in the ball game. Jamie Smith, a bright spot for UAPB, freshman running back out of Camden Fairview. set for the snap here under center. Ben Anderson is going to hand it off to Smith off the right side, a cutback. Breaks one tackle up to the 14-yard line, a gain of four on the play for Smith. Well, he looks like he's going to be a good one. Thrust into action, still sitting out Billings and Legron. Hope to get those guys back. But Smith and Young have taken over early on in the season here, getting all the carries. 1 yard gain there by Jamie Smith. So going to bring up third down and five for the Golden Lions at their own 15. 3:26 and counting in this one. Shotgun just to the left of Ben Anderson is going to be Jamie Smith. On this third down and five play, play clock down to 10. Takes the snap, fires, got a man open. It's Cody Swain, and he's got the first down. Does Swain up to the 29-yard line. Little quick strike pass, little go route. Quick fire and a first down for UAPB. Defense really can't do a whole lot with that unless they're just jumping the route. It'll move the chains for the Golden Lions here. Shotgun snap, no backs. Cranks it up, fires it deep up the right side, and it's intercepted at the UAPB 37-yard line. Intended for Eckwood. And trying to get the number there, looks and picked off by Shea Nutt out of Brenham, Texas. 6'2", 180, freshman cornerback. Now McNeese State will run the clock out pretty much, just 2:29 remaining. McNeese State leading 58-14. Pretty good ball game going into the second quarter, as we were tied at 14 early in the second quarter, and then McNeese State took control, got a couple of breaks to go their way, and the momentum swung as Eaglin breaks a tackle. The big fullback is rumbling into the secondary and all the way up to the UAPB 35-yard line. They'll give him the 36-yard line officially. The big fullback rips off a big gainer there. 2:15 and counting. Briscoe back in there at quarterback for McNeese. With just 2 minutes left, they will work the clock. Eaglin will continue to carry the football for the Cowboys as he takes another delayed handoff, this time to the left, trying to get outside. And he's got the corner up to the 24-yard line and out of bounds. Gain of about 11, another first down. No matter who they've put in there, they have ran the ball hard all night. Several different running backs have shared the wealth for McNeese State. You can tell by watching this, a very good football team. UAPB has played two really solid non-conference teams right off the bat at Arkansas State and at McNeese State. And now taking a knee is Briscoe, as he'll take the knee with a minute 40 remaining. A couple of more of those and this one will be done. Auburn went on to beat Arkansas State 38-9 in that ball game, if you were wondering. Another knee coming up here for Briscoe with just over a minute remaining.
Well, that's Briscoe. Takes the knee.
Makes it third down and 14. 54 seconds and counting. One more kneel down should do it. Briscoe in victory formation. Takes the knee with 32 seconds left, and that's going to be the ball game. Final score coming up here on this one. Final score, 58-14 is the final as McNeese State cruises to victory. UAPB fought tough early and looked like we were going to have a really good ball game tonight, and then McNeese State just kind of took over there at the midway point of the second quarter, and it was all she wrote after that. So we put our final touches on this one for Finley Hill back in the studio, and myself, Tim Stubbs, here tonight flying solo as we wrap things up. 58-14, our final. McNeese State wins it big. The Golden Lions finally returning home. Looking forward to that next week at Golden Lions Stadium. We'll see if UAPB can turn things around, hopefully next week against Alabama State. Their home opener, their conference opener, a clean slate. Everything's still in play as far as the SWAC championship is concerned, and we'll see if UAPB can get it going next week and turn things around. But I like the effort tonight. It just wasn't happening with a very good McNeese State team. They made some adjustments and then took over the game in the second quarter. But I saw a lot of positives here tonight for UAPB, and feel good about going into that game next week against Alabama State. I'm Tim Stubbs saying so long from Lake Charles, Louisiana, here from McNeese State University. The Cowboys of McNeese State win 58-14 over the Golden Lions. We say so long and good night from Lake Charles, Louisiana.